I always was sketching in class. I used to get in trouble for sketching in class. I used to get my notebooks taken away for sketching in class. So, you know, I always did that. And like some of my classmates, they were like, oh, you know, I have, you know, prom is coming up. You know, I want you to make my dress. I was like, dude, I don't know how to sew. I was like, I don't know how to sew, but I could design it for you. And so I just sketched out, you know, the thing, and they would go get it made. And it was really amazing. At that point, it was like the first time I'd seen something that I created come to life. And ever since then, I was just like, this is like what I want to do.
So when you were in California paying your dues, I guess, was there ever a lowest point for you out there? Like, maybe this is not going to work out.
People would hire you and then like wanting to pay you basically nothing. So that was very difficult. And, you know, at first I didn't think, you know, about doing a business, just doing the business side of it. I really was just want to go and work for a company and just kind of build my way up and become a head designer. And then I just found out that wasn't really what I wanted to do. I interned for this amazing designer in LA, and she was doing the type of things that I wanted to do. And I did an internship with her for a while, and she kind of like showed me that I could do it on my own and how to do it and what she did and how she would reach out to like buyers and boutiques and stuff like that. So after that, I moved to the Bay Area and was doing stuff in San Francisco for like a while. Okay. And I actually built my brand there. And it was like, I made so many connections so fast, and I got my stuff in boutiques over there. I started like making cold calls and just going around showing my collection, showing people what I had, and just networking. And it just took off from there. You know, I didn't know if it was going to ever, if I was going to ever even make a sale.
Can you describe like your first show, like what was going on?
Oh my God. The first show was like a mess. It was like so unorganized. And I'm very like strict on like being organized and having everything together and trying to plan stuff. And, you know, I wasn't used to like just, I mean, I've done fashion shows at my school and I've done shows as a model, but you know, just doing my own collection, it's a lot of like work into it. A lot of things that you don't know that you have to get together and you have to just kind of do on the spot, as opposed to trying to like, and even now, if I do a show, there's going to be something that I have to do on the spot, which I really don't like doing, but it happens. And you just kind of have to go with it and just jump into it. My last show that I did that was really, really amazing, there was still some craziness behind the set. It still wasn't like, it was the best show that I've ever done, but it was still like, okay, this is a mess, but it's always like that.
Being in this industry as a woman of color, like what like challenges have you faced?
When I go places, I mean, I'm immediately judged. People just don't think that I know things. They always assume that I'm inexperienced or I don't know, you know, the professional terms, or I haven't worked in the industry long enough. They always assume that. So I have to kind of school them when I go into it. And then they're like, oh, okay, well, you know, but that's like a big assumption. And I've had a lot of that even here, like living in Texas. Like I didn't have as much of that in California. Like people are a bit more open, but here it's like, it's so hard to like work with people here.
From creative to creative, like, what voices do you hear in your head as while you're sketching and doing these things? Like, What do you hear and how do you overcome that?
I do have doubts a lot of the times. I'm always worried how things will be perceived, and sometimes it makes me go back and change things that I probably shouldn't have. And sometimes I'm asking other people for their opinions, because it's always good to like kind of step back. And if somebody sees your thing in a different way, it's kind of always good to get their opinion that way, because you may see thing one way and then they'll say like, oh, well this. And then I kind of like ask my sister and my husband their opinions, and people I know, like really close personal friends and family. Okay, what do you think about this? What's your first thought? And then sometimes if I feel really strong about it, then I just won't change it. I'm like, I like it the way it is. But I have had so many doubts about, especially presenting fashion shows. You know, there's so many important people there. There's, you know, photographers, and I'm just like, what if they don't like it? What if it goes down the runway and they think it's really bad? What if this scene looks really bad? You know? So, but I'm just like, okay, just do it, and if we'll see what happens. It was the most amazing feeling to have that happen, because it was like the first time I have something on like a national TV show that everybody knows and everybody watches. And it was really amazing because I didn't know, you know, it was going to happen. And it actually aired on my birthday, which was like the best thing ever. So I watched the show, and just seeing her in the dress, and then they had it on their Facebook page and then their Instagram, and she was like dancing in a dress, and people were like, I love her outfit the best. Like, she had the cutest dress. And I was just like, it's my dress.
I think fashion industry and designer, a lot of people probably think like Devil Wears Prada type atmosphere.
Yeah, like I'm like, it's not like that anymore. Like, I mean, some people put on like this little like facade that they feel like they have to be that way. Mm-hmm. I'm generally not that way. I guess because I like a lot of other things too, like with design, like the cosplay, the comic book. I'm a gamer by heart, so I like other things, but I also really love fashion. But I'm not like, oh well, I have to wear these really high pumps. I'm like, no, I like to wear shoes like that sometimes, but I'm not gonna be walking around with my nose in the air thinking I'm the best one. I like to chit chat with other designers, like when we do fashion shows, I like to go over and I'm like, oh, this is so amazing with your design. And, you know, I like to get to know them. But there are some people that they're like in their own corner and they're sitting there doing this. They don't want to chit chat with you. And so. I would love to have like a bridal line, just like in like every major boutique store. I don't really want to do like stuff for Bloomingdale's or Macy's. That seems like a lot of people's goals, but I don't want to do that because I feel like I would have to compromise too much of like my design concept to meet their expectations. But I would just like to have like my stuff in like some boutiques, you know, bridal boutiques and things like that. I really want to have like a really big established bridal brand. Oh my gosh, I would have said start sewing now and start doing the design now and go to New York instead. And California was really great, but I don't know, I probably would have wanted to see what it would have been like to be in New York in my early 20s and see what that would have been like. I would say just kind of don't take life too serious. Just kind of be in the moment and just do what you want to do. I mean, when you're younger, you don't have as much doubt as you do when you're older. You don't think about things, you just do it. So I would love to have that younger me ambition.
How do you define your why?
Well, for me, it's just been something that I've always loved. And I guess it comes from my my father's background. I was told that my grandmother, that I never met, used to sew and design things and put on community fashion shows. And my father used to sew his own suits and things. So I guess it just comes from like my background and just kind of in my blood. Hi, my name is Dominique Ansari. My company is Dominique Ansari. Dominique Ansari is my excuse. What's yours?